to play your flute.
Exhilarating, because it has a lot of connection. It's freestyle, you just got to connect with the other person. Usually you're trying to one-up the other person, you're kind of one-up the other person, but you're both connected. For some reason there's a great chi, a flow of energy, and it's very artistic, really.
Wing Chun Kung Fu was created in China around 400 years ago by a Shaolin nun named Meng Moy.
She created it from a mixture of different varieties of art from the wushu itself that came from the temples.
Meng Moy created this art as a style that was effective against other styles at the time. She took snake kung fu and crane kung fu and combined them into one single style. The style at the time had no name when it created it. She later taught that style to a young girl named Yim Wing Chun.
She was able to go into the temple simply because she, you know, she was a high nun, as others weren't able to do. She took dibs and dabs of different parts of the art and began to mix it together. And with the cooperation of the other chief abbots, they decided to do this together, making a unique style which is easy to learn. For the actual peasant people, since there was an upcoming uprising against the Manchu itself.
Legend has it that Yim Wing Chun, the first disciple of Meng Moy, learned the entire style in 1 year. So it's designed to be learned in a short period of time. It's not going to take years to master, unlike some other arts around.
Wing Chun itself, it may be an old art, as people say, just like other martial arts, but yet it's not old because it's a constant evolving art. It means creativity.
It's also made to be effective, so any and everyone can learn this art and learn to use this art in an effective way. As a martial artist, we really don't propagate the use of violence. We use martial arts as a tool for self-improvement and self-mastery. So Wing Chun, we really like to, through Wing Chun, we like to focus on students overcoming their fear or overcoming their self-doubts or overcoming their shortcomings and their weaknesses. And Wing Chun and martial arts is a vehicle for that purpose alone.
Ang Wing Chun kasi angkop din sa mga Pilipino katulad natin kasi nga it doesn't deal much sa size. Like kasi nga ginawa siya ng babae. And then, yun nga, unlike ng mga ibang martial arts or mga sports, siguro na kailangan talaga matangkad o mahaba ang kamay, like for boxing siguro. Sa Wing Chun kasi, it's a very versatile art na parang tubig siya na it can be combined with anything. So kahit na sa size nating mga Filipino and sa adaptability ng Pinoy na matuto ng iba't ibang klaseng art na nag-excel tayo doon, like for boxing example. So siguro Filipinos would do better in Wing Chun.
So what's unique about Wing Chun is it doesn't focus on brute force or brute strength. Wing Chun focuses on positioning, power, speed, and relaxation to develop strength or power within a strike. So it's a different philosophy. So a lot of physical strength is not necessary to learn Wing Chun and to learn Wing Chun to a point where it can be used effectively for self-defense or for an exercise routine or as a martial art in general for the benefits that martial arts bring to life or whatever purpose they serve in the practitioner's life.